A year ago, Nastia Lukin became the best gymnast on the planet Earth. And what a year it has been for this girl. She has traveled the country, and she has traveled the world, and she has just about done everything an Olympic champion can do. She has won awards. She's made an appearance on Oprah, on Leno. She's met the president. She's won every conceivable award, including the USOC Sports Woman of the Year. I think she stepped in for Maria Sharapova at Wimbledon for a set, and I do believe she even saved a cat on the way to the arena today. This girl can do it all. She reached the pinnacle with her father right there, winning the most coveted medal at the Olympic Games, the women's all-around. But she is not done. She is back, and this is her live, getting ready to compete in her first competition since winning that Olympic gold medal. She is not done. She still has that fire. She might have grown up a little bit, but one thing that has not changed is she still has that drive, and she does not want to give up being a world-class gymnast. Welcome to the CoverGirl Classic in Des Moines, Iowa, where all S's are silent. My name is John Roethlisberger, and I'm here with my 2000 Olympic teammate, Tasha Schweiker. Tasha, this is an exciting time. We're here to see not only the past, but possibly the future of American gymnastics.
John, I am so excited to be here at the 2009 CoverGirl Classic. It's going to be a great competition, and it's going to be good to see the new faces of our next generation.
And it's fun to be here and see Nastia out there on the floor again. I know she has been so amazing, not just last year, but all the years leading up. But she is also going to be joined by her Olympic teammate today in her first competition back, Sam Peschek. And there she is, just getting the groove back and feeling those nerves a little bit, she mentioned yesterday. But she says she likes it. She likes to be back out on that competition floor.
That's right. This is Sam's first big competition since the gym switch. She's now training with Bridget Sloan at Marvin Sharp's gym. So she's in good hands.
And I will never forget being in Beijing and watching that team come out on the floor without Sam. She gets hurt in the warm-up gym. She still competed in the team prelims, but quite an adjustment the team had to make, but she still brought home that silver medal and an amazing experience for her. On the other hand, we have the future right there, Sabrina Vega, and she is going to be a fun girl to watch as well.
I talked to Sabrina before the competition today, and she is so ecstatic to be out here on the floor with the seniors. I asked her, you know, you've been working out in the group with Nastia Lukin. How is that? Gave me the biggest smile in the world. Just could not believe she was in the same training group as her idol.
When we return, the past meets the future as we lay the first brick on the road to London. We will be live from Des Moines, Iowa when we return.
The CoverGirl Classic is being brought to you by CoverGirl. Check out CoverGirl Lash Blast and Lash Blast Lux at CoverGirl.com.
Welcome back to Veterans Memorial Auditorium here in Des Moines, Iowa, as we get ready for competition. One more look at Olympic champion Nastia Lukin in her first competition back. And I kind of wonder myself, does she still get nervous? I mean, here we are in Des Moines, Iowa. I mean, it's halfway around the world from Beijing, China, where she won an Olympic gold medal. You'd think it would be the easiest thing in the world for her. Here we go, first up on the balance beam, Sabrina Vega. We mentioned her in the open as one of the up-and-coming stars for the United States. She's still a junior, but definitely somebody to watch as the years roll by as we get closer to London.
Sabrina is one of the four juniors competing in the senior session tonight.
Coached by a couple of Olympians herself, only 14 years old as we saw. Coached by Saren and Teodora, both from Romania, both Olympians. So quite the leadership in her gym.
That was a Fenarial by Can Swing Layout step out. Now we're gonna see that series a lot today. With the new code, most of the connections are only worth 1/10 in connection bonus. For an aerial, back handspring layout step out is one that's worth 2.
That was Kimberly Jacob of Superior Gymnastics on the even bonus. Up next on bars at the Capital National Center will be Brooke Parker.
Her coach, Teodora, was actually a teammate of Nadia Kalmanich in 1976 when Nadia got the perfect 10. And won the gold medal. So I was talking to her a little bit before the competition. Ironically enough, Teodora was also coached by Marta and Bella back in the day. And one thing that evidently Teodora and Marta have in common is they're both very strict and demanding. But Sabrina also mentioned that her coaches are kind of like her second parents to her. Hey, anytime you can stay on the beam, first rotation, that's got to be a good sign. And there's Teodora, 1976 Olympian.
Wonderful routine. Now, we saw the full turn there, big wobble. And again, just like the old code, a full turn is part of an element that needs to be done.
And here we go with one of the alternates for the 2008 Olympic team. Yana Beeger had not really the experience she hoped to have, Tasha, going into 2008, especially after a great 3 years leading up to those games. Was the alternate, didn't get to go on the floor, and kind of was a little bit of a bitter pill for her to swallow.
That's right. I talked to Yana's mother, Andrea, before the meet, and she talked about how in the alternate situation, it was kind of unfortunate for Yana because she didn't get the fair chance. Two of the girls that were on the team were injured. However, they were not replaced with the alternates like they should have been.
The first event that Yana has to tackle is going to be the vault, and not really one of her best events, and kind of the new rules have kind of hurt her a little bit on this event. Is that right, Tasha?
That's right. Yurchenko 1.5 in the old code used to be worth a 5.5. In the new code, they have decreased it 2/10 down to a 5.3. So there's a bigger gap between the 1.5 and the double being worth a 5.8. Very nice, clean 1.5, just a small hop in the landing.
Not going to be a big score, though, most likely. But again, comes out of the gate strong. You can see her mom working with her a little bit there. I talked to Andrea, her mom, a little bit before the competition, and one thing she did say is that she's actually an easy gymnast to coach, which, you know, being coached by my dad back in the day, we always didn't get along all that great. We kind of butted heads once in a while, but she said she's easy to coach because we can communicate, we can talk about things more so than some of the other gymnasts in her gym. Another look at Yana's vault.
It's a nice entry, very good form in the air. It's a little short on the landing, could have had a little more height.
Yana Beeger, 19 years old, and she's taking it year by year. She's going to see how this year goes, wants to make the world team, and then after that's done, decide if she wants to go on and continue to train for another world championships and possibly for Lunda. The score for Sabrina Vega, you can see a 14.05. And that is a decent score. You know, we talked about this earlier tonight. What's a good score under the new code? And a 14, we haven't seen a lot of those under the new code. A 15 seems to be a great score as of right now.
15 is a great score. And the score is going to go down from the last code because of the requirements going from 10 elements to 8 elements. 8 being on vault, or excuse me, on beam and floor, 5 tumbling, and 3 dance. So you will see the scores lower here.
Back over to the balance beam, we got Ivana Hong, 16 years old, and she has had quite a tumultuous year. Yes, I do have my word of the day toilet paper I got that off of. She has had a change of gyms as well, and she's down in Texas now at Woga training with Nastia. You know, Tasha, going into 2008, my thought about Ivana was, man, this girl from 2007 to 2008 is going to be one to watch. But she had some injuries, she had some obstacles to overcome, and really didn't pan out, I think, the way a lot of people thought she would.
I agree. I mean, in coming into the Olympic year, she was on fire, a very clean gymnast, hit almost all the time, and it was just very unfortunate to see her as an alternate on the team. But she ended up taking 4 months off after the Olympic Games, regrouped, and moving gyms from Alfong's gym, Gage, and now is at Wolga. And she looks like she's doing pretty well.
This is something I want to talk to you about, too, and you experienced this, Tasha. Taking time off after an Olympic Games for someone who's never taken a day off, and you take 4 months off, and we know Ivana's done that. Nastia's had a little bit more time off than she's used to. Sam had to take some time off. How hard is that for someone who's never been out of shape to get back into top form?
You know, I think age has a lot to do with it. When I was 15 after the 2000 Olympics, I took about 4 months off, but being so young, I felt like I could bounce back really quick into it. Someone like Nastia, who has never taken a day off, and all of a sudden, every week she's traveling, she's taking 3 days off and only training four. It's harder for her, but yet, again, you know, she's still been in every training camp, every opportunity to be there with the girls. So for someone like her, it's not going to be too bad.
And there's her new coach, Valeri, probably the coolest cat in the competition. Just as an athlete watching him, he was amazing. And we will be back. Keep that lazy boy in the reclined position. We'll be back with more gymnastics live from Des Moines in moments. 19-year-old Nastia Lukin getting ready for her balance beam routine in a few moments. But before that, we are going to go over to the uneven bars and 17-year-old Olivia Courtney from Orlando Metro in Orlando, Florida. Her coach, Jeff Wood, probably one of the giants of the sport of women's gymnastics, both literally and figuratively. The big man, you can see him in the background right there, looking on.
You know, John, he's actually a football player. You realize that?
You know what? I did not know that, but it does not surprise me.
Olivia is a really powerful bar worker. She's got a lot of releases.
That's the power you're talking about, Tasha. Right there, those release moves definitely get some air time.
That's right. However, we've seen a few missed handstands, and her lines are a little questionable.
When you say lines, tell the layman what you mean exactly by that.
The part from her hips to her quads, you know, there's a pike where the butt is, and we needs to be straight. Every pike, the judges could take a tenth, up to 3/10, even with the new code, maybe even 5/10.
And from what I remember from Beijing and even seeing the gymnastics this year, the execution part of the score, the judges do not hold back. They are brutal. What a routine that looks flawless, they come up with a point of deductions. And as someone who knows gymnastics, I'm still baffled by how they find all those deductions.
That's right. Execution and the new code, they're hitting really hard. John, you know, we were looking through the scores of a Japan meet that the girls went to, and the execution scores were ridiculous. We're talking 7.8s, 8.8s, just really, really hard on execution these days.
You know, when I talked to Nastia earlier this summer, we talked about, you know, what she was going to do the next few years, and here she is getting that focus that we've become familiar with. But the one thing that amazed me is she really has that fire, that love for doing the sport of gymnastics, and she really wants to get back out on that floor. Quickly over to the beam, we got Briley Casanova, also from WOGA. Nastia will follow her. Briley's only 14 years old.
That's right, another one of the juniors here in the senior competition.
Briley, another one of those that you talked to, I think, before the competition about how fun and exciting it is to be in that same gym with Nastia, and every day she's a little bit in awe.
That's right. She was telling me, I asked her, you know, how is it training with Nastia Liukin every day? She's an Olympic champion. She goes, you know, Tasha, I'm honestly starstruck every day. And I can't believe that she's continuing like she is. She still looks great. And it's just inspiring.
And she's not bad. You know, we talked a lot about Sabrina coming in this competition as a junior that could be an up-and-coming star. But, you know, 3 years is a lot of time to make some big jumps, and this girl's got some of the foundation definitely to build on. Certainly she's in the right gym. And on cue, my curse comes true and she falls right when I say something wonderful, but she's in the right place if she wants to go somewhere big.
Most definitely. And, you know, being out there with the seniors today is definitely a great experience for her.
Oof. Oh, and you can see that right off the beam. She did not get up.
That's right. Right on the takeoff, there was no punch whatsoever.
The cannonball off the end of the beam is not the way you want to finish, but still. Oh, and there she is, the queen of USA Women's Gymnastics. Right now, what's she saying? You've been there. What's coming out of her mouth? Give me a little insight, Tasha.
I think she's saying, why didn't she punch the beam? Same thing I'm saying, you know.
Talking to someone who knows her well, also world champion 1991, Kim Zemeskal, now one of the best coaches in the country. There she is, the queen. Thinking about her training now and thinking about her and her gym, I imagine leading up to the games, the intensity had to be just immense. They had that single-minded focus, her and her dad winning the Olympic Games. They weren't shy about, you know, expressing that desire and that goal. And now I imagine going into the gym, it's got to be a sense of relief, you know, that no matter what you do. And I mentioned that to her mom a little bit when I got to the gym yesterday. And she said, you know, even when you have a bad day, when things aren't going good, you can kind of pat yourself on the back and say, it's okay, I'm still Olympic champion.
And definitely, I mean, going to the Olympics, you give your blood, sweat, and tears day in and day out to go for that medal. And Nastia gave everything she had and, you know, achieved her goal. So it's good to see now she can still continue, go back in the gym, and have some fun.
And her dad, Valeri, I had the opportunity to watch compete and also compete against. I started my international career when he was kind of finishing his, and I always was just, he was the gymnast I never could be. He was the trickster. He could pull anything out of the hat, and that was definitely not me as a gymnast. So I sat back and I watched him, and on just when he walked on the floor, and you can still see it, he's got that strut. You know, he might be a little man, but he's got the stature and the aura that is bigger than this whole arena. So it's fun to, for me as a fan of his when I was a gymnast, to see him out on the floor. So is she still get nervous? I mean, really?
You know, as great of a competitor as Nastia is, she still gets nervous. You know, being on tour with her for 2.5 months, even in the show sometimes she get nervous, and I had to be like, it's okay, it's just a show.
It's okay, you're the Olympic champion.
Right?
Did you forget that? Her first performance since Beijing.
You know, and let's note this performance for Nastia, you know, she's not here to qualify for Visa Championships. It's really just an exhibition to get her out there. She really just came because she wanted to compete and, you know, just be out in the spotlight again, competing with her teammates.
And this is the only event that she's going to do tonight as well. You know, she doesn't look like she's quite in the shape that she was in Beijing, obviously, and I don't think anyone would expect that. But it's funny because talking to her, you know, outside of the competition, she's like, oh, I'm terrible, I'm not in the shape I want to be. But watching her on bars, you and I are both like, yeah, right. I mean, come on, seriously, everybody in this arena would die to be able to do what you do. So maybe she's not an Olympic champion shape right now, but, you know, out of shape for Nastia is in awesome shape for a lot of people.
That is correct. And I mean, her beam looks great.
Beautiful. Come on. You got to give us a little wobble. I mean, you can't be perfect, right?
All right, round off layout. Exhibition routine, of course.
I'll tell you what, that looked pretty darn good. I mean, she watered down the dismount, obviously, but, you know, for the layman looking on in that routine, there was a lot of tough stuff. A lot of stuff I remembered seeing in Beijing as well. And honestly, I'm not a judge, but watching that routine, a lot of stuff looked just as good as it did a year ago. I imagine that's got to be a relief. I mean, even though she knows this is an exhibition, she also knows that everyone is watching her. Everyone in this arena was waiting for that minute and a half right there. And there's a lot of young girls that want to be her. And there's Mom. I wonder if Mom watched the routine. You know, Mom, I talked to her about that too. She never watches the routine. I go, you going to watch the routine tomorrow? She goes, I think I will. Yeah, we'll see about championships. And if she's in London, I bet she's not watching it again.
Good for her. Yeah, I remember being at meet, seeing her in the back, pacing. She couldn't watch Nastia. I think I even heard something at the Olympics. She had to stay back at the hotel because she couldn't even come to the arena to watch her.
Look at Valeri. He doesn't even care. Whatever. Valeri does. He's watched, talking to Ivana, and he can care less. Nastia's over on the other side. Looks like she's having fun, though. Mom looks relieved a little bit as well. I got to ask her if that's a first time. She must have watched her when she was a little kid, I gotta think.
Probably when she was a little kid, but the moment she came to Elite, I don't think she did.
So you go to the judges, we go to the judges, another team.
You know, just being out of the sport and just having an objective point of view, it's funny. You know, Nastia's super nervous about doing this exhibition beam routine and, you know, just really hyped up, but very, very nervous and kind of feels like maybe there's people here judging her. But the funny thing is, these people really could care less if she came here to do a beam routine. They would come just to see her, sign autographs, just to see her be in the arena.
Yeah. You know, as far as goals for Nastia, I know talking to her, she wants to be the most decorated American gymnast ever. And she's won 5 Olympic and 9 world medals. Shannon Miller has won a total of 16. And, you know, I know it's a friendly rivalry there, but I know she wants to have that title of having the most world and Olympic medals. She's got a little work to do. I mean, it's not easy to win those world and Olympic medals. We'll see what she can do. And here we go with Reagan Corville, 16 years old from Elite Gymnastics.
This is a face we haven't seen before.
Now, a couple years ago, Reagan, as a junior, won the Classics, and at that time, really had a bright future. Talking to her coach, Johnny Moyal, before the competition, said, you know, at that time, she was on the verge of awesomeness. Is that a word? Can I say awesomeness?
I think you can.
She was on the verge of awesomeness, and she had an elbow injury that kept her out of competition for a year, and now he feels like she's healthy. There's nothing holding her back, and you can see in his eye that he's got that little bit of a twinkle, like this girl can do something special.
If that's the case, you know, she's right on track. She has 2 more years of high school left. So 2012 definitely could be in the mix. She's kind of all over the beam here today. As we can see there, she missed a few of her connections. So I can't imagine her start value is going to be very high.
And I would guess that this might be the first time in her life that she's ever gone up after an Olympic champion. Imagine she's got to be a little bit nervous, but you know what? Stayed on. There's her coach, Johnny. Kind of a unique story about Johnny as well. He actually found Carly Patterson. I just learned this before the competition. Kind of a cool story. He's from Baton Rouge, and he had a birthday party at his gym. And who should be at the birthday party he was hosting at the gym but a young little Carly Patterson. And he saw her bouncing on the trampoline and said, that girl could be something special. Talked to her aunt in the office and said, you got to bring her in here. And obviously, the rest is history. She did move to another gym because her dad got relocated, but Kind of a unique story. We will be back soon. That is the end of Rotation 1. More live gymnastics coming from Des Moines, Iowa in a few moments. Taking a look at Des Moines' own Shawn Johnson with her partner from Dancing with the Stars. Talk about having a whirlwind, just like Nastia Lukin. And Shawn Johnson has been across the country a few hundred times doing everything you can imagine and having a great time being an Olympic champion of her own. And standings early, obviously these don't mean a whole lot early in the competition, but Ivana Hong taking an early lead, but there's a lot of gymnastics yet to come, and for Ivana doesn't mean a whole lot because she's already qualified to the championships. But let's talk about what we saw in that first rotation, namely Nastia Lukin. Tasha, grade her out. What's your feeling on Nastia Lukin at this point? Her beam routine, is it what you expected? Is it more than you expected?
Oh, definitely. I mean, for her just to be in the arena tonight is way more than anyone expected, I think. She's been traveling so much. She's won so many awards, has so many opportunities to get out there and do things like Dancing with the Stars and such, and she's here. So we're excited to have her.
There's another aspect of this competition, and that's the girls that need to qualify. There's about a dozen girls that have not qualified to the U.S. Championships. Obviously, we have some of the veterans that are here to get experience, to do those exhibition routines, to kind of get in that mode of getting ready for championships. But for some girls, this could be the end of the road if they don't perform well and qualify to the U.S. Championships, which are in a couple weeks.
That's right. Of the 26 girls that are competing tonight, there are 12 of them that have not qualified.
And the Visa Championships, the 13th, 14th, and 15th of August, will be televised live, so we're excited about that, and hopefully we'll see some more of the veterans that who aren't here, because we have had some injuries for some of the best. Jordan Weber, who won the American Cup earlier this year, is not here. Some of the top dogs hopefully will be back in shape and getting ready to compete at that competition.
That's right. One of our favorites we saw in training, Rebecca Bross, will not be competing today in 3 events. She hurt her ankle in training, so she'll just be competing on bars.
There's another one right there, Sam Peschek. who we talked about a little bit in the open. We're going to get to see her on one of her best events of all. Not doing the all-around yet. She's had a tumultuous year as well, recovering from that ankle injury that she sustained in Beijing. Just getting back in the swing of things. But again, like Nastia, wants to get back out on that floor, let everybody know, hey, I'm still competing and I still want to be remembered and be in the mix come Visa Championship time. There's Jana Beeger and Andrea, her mom, talking about the next event. One of her better events, the uneven bars, coming up. We'll see what she can do there. And you know, looking back in 2008, it really was kind of a bitter time for her, because at one point, I'll never forget Bella Carolla being on live television saying, Jana Beeger is a shoe-in. She's going to be on that team. And, you know, for her, you have that mindset as an athlete. You know, I'm going to be on this team. I want to be on this team. And for somebody who is a silver medalist at the World Championships just 2 years before the Olympic Games, to not be on there has got to be just brutal. A couple of teammates we saw there, Sam and Nastia. They're kind of relaxed. They're probably talking about, you know, boys and her new Vanilla Star jeans that Nastia has. It's good to see them out there relax a little bit. You always see the girls with that stone look on their face of intensity, and you rarely get to see them just relax and having a good time, so it's kind of fun to see them really enjoying themselves and each other.
Right there we see Jana Beeger getting ready for her bar set.
Talk about that. Marta's probably saying, yeah, when you did that, you know, that last dance, you know, you totally didn't point your toes. Your leg was bent. What is wrong with you? Seriously. Back to competition. Jana Beeger on bars.
Ooh, it looks like she hit her foot on the floor. Now with the new code of points, that'll be a point deduction, which is huge.
Wow, just for hitting that. That's the same as a fall, hitting your foot on the floor.
That's right.
That's what I call brutal. It kind of makes me not want to hit my foot on the floor. This is an event for Jana where this could have put her on the Olympic team. You know, Chelsea Memel, who's great on bars, had an ankle injury in Beijing, but they still wanted to keep her on for bars. And I'm sure Jana was sitting there waiting, come on, give me my chance, give me my chance. And when it didn't come, I'm sure it was not a good feeling for her. And here's another girl who did not quite get her opportunity, also an alternate for that 2008 Olympic team. And we mentioned how she switched gyms and moved from Gage in Missouri to Woga in Texas. And I talked to her before the competition, and she said for a couple months, she just trained herself. She found a gym in Kansas City, Dave's Gymnastics, I think she said it was called, and she went in and she just conditioned and worked some basic stuff on her own until she decided where she wanted to go, and she ended up going to one of the best.
Well, it's definitely what you call commitment. I mean, for a gymnast at this level to train themselves without a coach who has coached for many years, it's difficult. Looks like she's in a good situation now at Woga. Right, you see the step out of the tumbling pass as if it's a landing step. Now, in this competition, that is okay and it will not be deduction. However, in the new code of points, there's a new built-in deduction for landing steps. The women's side of gymnastics are literally going to have to stick their passes just like the men do.
So, if, correct me if I'm wrong, but you're saying they're raising their standards to be more like the guys, because I want to make sure I understand.
Stop, John.
Now, that step you're talking about, people are like, of course, but they always had that free step, kind of, where they could land on 2 feet and put their foot back and kind of finish their pass, but that step's not going to be allowed, and that's what you're referring to, correct?
Right. I'm referring to the step out of the pass, and really, I thought it was just a step of artistry. You know, it was the beauty of women's gymnastics. Guys, they stick it. It's not so girly, so...
So you're saying men's gymnastics is not beautiful?
No.
little trouble in that 2.5 for Ivana, but... You know what, she showed some power, pike pull in right out of the gate, and this is one event that hasn't been necessarily her best, but, you know, Valeria's got her moving in the right direction. I think I saw a smile. Is that considered a smile?
I'm pretty sure it was a smile.
She had an injury, broken ankle or foot, I believe, in 2008 that she worked through, which really held her back. But obviously this is an event that that would affect. And Larry did mention that this is a place that he still needs work, but looks like they're doing all right. Going over to the uneven bars, talk about future stars. This is a girl right here, Bridget Cacquato.
I think they call her Bridgie.
Bridgie?
That's her nickname, Bridgie.
Very unique. I don't know how they came up with that. Bridgie, but
she looks like a Bridgie, come on.
But she's a lot of fun to watch. We watch her in practice, especially on this event, the uneven bar. She's got some big swing and some big releases. Her big sister, Mackenzie, we saw her last year at the Olympic Trials, and definitely a contender going into the Visa Championships in a couple weeks. But this girl right here, her coaches think has got a legit shot at London in 2012.
You know, I was watching Bridgie in training, and she's got great lines on bars. I thought it was her strong event, but talking to her coach, Johnny, she actually said bars is her weakness. She has consistency issues, and she gets very nervous in competition.
Come on.
Way to work it out.
Not supposed to be a press handstand, but she made it. Avoided that fall or that extra swing, which could have been catastrophic.
Well, she stayed on the bar. And not to mention, she's one of the juniors in this senior competition.
And she's going to contend against those seniors for the all-around, no doubt. Moving over to the vault, 17-year-old Sam Peschek. First opportunity to see her tonight on one of her best events, one of the events that really helped vault her literally onto the Olympic team.
Beautiful Yurchenko double full.
Looked very similar to the Olympic trials last year. Unfortunately, we didn't get to see it in the Olympic Games because of the injury, but definitely an area where she can help Team USA quite a bit. Her new coach, Marvin Sharp, she said she loves being at the gym with her teammate from the Olympic team, Bridget Sloan. And we will be back in Des Moines in moments for more gymnastics live on Universal Sports. Back in Des Moines, Iowa, we're taking a look at Sam Peschek, who just finished her vault, and there's her score of 14.95. And if that holds true to what we talked about before, Tasha, a pretty decent score. A 15 on vault is nothing to sneeze at.
That's right, but I see her, you know, folding her arms, and I think before we came on, she kind of said, geez. So I know she seems disappointed, but she has to realize the score is going to be lower because of the new code.
Well, almost a point off. You saw the execution at 9.15, and I'll be honest with you, I mean, it looked pretty good. She landed a little short of the twist, took a step, but man, I mean, it's the gauntlet out there.
They are cutthroat.
Sam committing to UCLA, your
That's
alma
right.
mater.
That's
you pretty
right.
excited
the
about
room?
That? Another girl who committed to UCLA right here, Olivia Courtney, coming off her uneven bar performance, which was about a 14.4. Not a bad score there. See if she can continue that role here on the balance beam. And she is actually one of the athletes who has already qualified. So for her, like Nasty and Sam, this is more of an exhibition or a warm-up for the Visa Championship.
And we see that series again, front aerial backhandspring layout step out, but there was no connection there, so she's definitely not getting the bonus. Again, looked like a little bit too much pause between that switchy back tuck. If I was a judge, I wouldn't give that connection either.
Talking with her coach, Jeff Wood, before the competition, he mentioned that she has a sore hamstring, and that's partly due to the fact that she's been busy this year. A lot of international events. She traveled overseas to the European Tour to Germany and France and a few other competitions as well. And so she's been busy. That hamstring has kind of taken some wear and tear, but she will do the all-around tonight, which is kind of exciting.
Beautiful dismount.
Two down, two to go for Orlando Metro's Olivia Courtney. There you can see the beast, Jeff Wood.
The beast. Linebacker.
You can hear him. He said, that's your deal, the floor and the vault. And that's really is where she excels, and we get a chance to see her, hopefully, on those two events. Moving over to the uneven bars, Mackenzie Cuquato, the older sister of Bridget. We mentioned her earlier. Only doing the uneven bars tonight, unfortunately, but definitely someone to watch heading into the Visa Championships, hopefully where she can get healthy.
That's right. 6 weeks ago, she actually fractured her knee, so that's what she's recovering from.
I mean, 6 weeks would be plenty of time to recover from that.
Oh, yeah. I broke my hand last week, and I'm perfect today. No, but she actually had a great summer. She competed in a few international competitions and placed top five in all of them. I was watching this routine in warm-up. She has the longest bar routine I think I've ever seen.
It is amazing, even watching the Olympics last year, some of the length of these bar routines, you can see water down that dismount.
That's right.
There's her coach, Yu Zhu, who was actually a coach on the for the Chinese women's team for the last 4 years, which quite interesting to be here helping American gymnastics at this point, but kind of a unique situation to be in.
Wonder how Marta feels about that one.
I think she has some questions she'd like to ask.
I'm sure.
Taking a look at Sabrina Vega.
On floor exercise, the score for Reagan Corville of
Elite. Getting ready to tumble. Yep, and there's her coach Teodora, the 1976 Olympic silver medalist teammate of Nadia Comaneci. And I don't believe she has ever dated any members of the 1984 Olympic team, from what I understand, but I can't verify that for sure.
Oh, that was really, really nice.
For a girl who's only had her first international competition this year, she's got some panache and she's got some promise, I would say.
Not to mention, she's so cute. You know, earlier today, I didn't know where she was from. She is like a beautiful mix. I found out she's actually Puerto Rican and Dominican.
Definitely a bright future. Hailing from Carmel, New York. She was also part of that Germany and France tour that some of the seniors and juniors took. She was actually over there with Bridget Cuquato and made quite a splash early in her career.
Hi, guys. It's Danaimi. I hope you're watching.
Yeah, we hope so too, don't we?
Nice performance.
Okay. Oh, she's so adorable.
She's got a high cute factor. Does that come into play in the sport at all, Tasha? Does that help?
I mean, if I was a judge, I'd give her a 16.
I thought you were going to say if I was competing, I'd get total cute factor points.
Of course you do.
Taking a look at Georgia DeBritz. And I was kind of hoping we'd get her on air. And I'm going to tell you why right now, because I get to plug the greatest university on the planet Earth. The University of Minnesota is where her brother Russell attends. And by the way, that's where I went to school too, in case you couldn't put that together.
Well, I remember. And I went to UCLA, just to, you know, throw that in there too.
Georgia 16 from Raleigh, Massachusetts. Her coach, Laura Tebow. She is trying to qualify here at this competition, so this is very important for her. Will her season continue or will it end today? And just to give you an idea of what these athletes need to do, if you're competing in the all-around, you have to average a score of 13.5. Basically, you have to get a total score of 54. If you're trying to qualify as a three-event athlete, you have to score a 43.5, which is essentially a 14.5 average. And if you're doing two events, you have to score a 30, which is a 15.0 average. So if we go back to what we talked about, the scores and what's considered a good score, if you're only doing two events, you better be good on them, basically, is what they're saying. And even if you're doing three, a 14.5 is a pretty legit score. So they're pretty demanding scores. 13.5 for the all-arounders, you know, isn't that high, but still, you're doing all-around, and it's demanding.
That's right, because if you look at the scores from after our first rotation, our leader, Ivana Hong, was only at, what, a 14.65?
Yep. She does have some big moves on bars.
Come on each. And she doesn't wear any grips. That's very uncharacteristic for an American gymnast. Ooh.
Come on.
Nice. Nice recovery.
It'll be interesting to see where that score is. You know, obviously it's not going to be the highest score on bars tonight, but let's look at that. When we get her score, look at it, how it compares to that 13.5 and how it plays into whether or not this girl can make it into the Visa Championships. There's her coach, Laura, with the big smile on her face. Pretty happy with that performance. A couple rotations down. We will be back in moments, and we have a special treat for you guys when we come back. Nastia turned media back in Des Moines in moments. Don't go away. We are back live in Veterans Memorial Auditorium in Des Moines, Iowa, and we have a special treat for all you gymnastics fans out there. Yes, she can pretty much do anything, include win an Olympic gold medal, and now she is behind the microphone. Nastia, is that comfortable for you? Are you okay back there holding the mic?
I definitely feel a little bit weird. I mean, I ran out of my leotard, put my jeans on real quick, so it's a little bit out of my comfort zone, but I'm still in the gym, so I'm here, happy to be here.
Nastia is going to be on the floor giving us her CoverGirl updates, but before we let you do that, tell us how it was to be back on the competition floor almost a year after competing at the Olympic Games.
Yeah, it's almost been a year, which is kind of crazy, but I was so excited to be here and to be able to compete. I know it was just beam and I didn't do my full routine, but it was just so exciting to finally be out here in the competition zone and get the first time under my belt. So it was a little shaky, but I had a lot of fun.
So Nastia, you're Olympic champion. Do you get nervous?
I do.
Even at a thing like this?
I know, and I was trying to tell myself, I was like, okay, I've been to the Olympics, and this is just a classic, but I still got a little bit nervous, but it was a lot of fun, and I'm just so happy to be out here again and doing what I love to do.
Awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, she is human.
I like how she says, I've been to the Olympics. She doesn't say, I won the Olympics. So for your CoverGirl update this rotation, I understand you have a champion of her own with you on the floor.
I do. I have a special guest with me today. We have Kim Zemesko, and I know you have some exciting news for us today, so would you like to tell everyone what that is?
I would love to share, but first of all, I would love to say how exciting it is to see you back out here in competition. But the big news is that we just started cheering this week. My husband, Chris, and I are expecting our third baby in February.
Congratulations. That's great. And then I know you had five girls that came to the Classic here in Des Moines. And how many of them qualified to the U.S. Championships?
Well, it was five girls who've never been to a U.S. Classic. They're brand new elites, so this whole environment has been really exciting. They're getting to do some nice dream building tonight watching the seniors. But three of them qualified to championships, so they'll be training to compete in Dallas.
That's awesome. And speaking of Dallas, we are both from Dallas. And how exciting is that? Do you think, obviously for me to be able to compete, I'm excited. But for the girls that have never been to a championships, to have that in their hometown, do you think that's going to help them or make them more nervous?
Well, ironically, my first championships was in my hometown where I was raised in Houston. And just knowing how that feels of the support from your family and the local crowd and everything like that and your gym teammates in there, it's going to be fantastic.
Cool. Thank you, Kim. And back to you guys, John and Tasha.
Well, Nastia, before we do that, seriously, do you want to just come up and take the headset? Because I think I'm pretty much about to lose my job. I mean, that was awesome.
Maybe next time.
How'd that feel? You feel natural out there? You feeling good?
Yeah. I mean, I think I want to compete for a little bit longer, but maybe after I'm done competing, I'll take up this.
I think Tasha and I want you to keep competing too. What do you think?
Oh, definitely. But I think she looks great out there. I mean, NBC needs to put you on salary.
Thank you.
Do you need an agent? Do you have one already? All right. Thanks. Thanks, Nastia.
Thank you.
Finishing the warm-up for the third rotation. And after two, looks like Ivana Hong still maintaining that lead again for her. The results don't make a whole lot of difference. There's a look at Ivana Hong. Has a 28.55, averaging just over a 14. But for her, again, being back on the floor like Nastia, like Sam, like Yana, getting back in the groove, letting people know, hey, I'm still here and I'm going to contend. There we go. And of course, I stand corrected. We have a couple of juniors, and I was looking at the senior results, just assuming that the senior would be in the lead, but we have a couple juniors at the top, which is quite amazing as well.
You know, as we talked about earlier, they are our future. The juniors in this competition, Sabrina, Rebecca Bross,
Bridget Caquato. Very exciting, and I'm sure for Marta and Kathy Kelly and the crew from USA Gymnastics to see those juniors up there has got to be a little bit of a relief. And here's another one. Amanda Jetter, who's got to have the coolest last name, 14 years old from Cincinnati, Ohio, comes from a gym with a long history of great gymnasts and Olympians, Cincinnati Gymnastics, coached by Mary Lee Tracy. Amanda really had to do a lot of work this year, coming back from a pretty bad hamstring injury in January that really kept her out for about 5 months. Mary Lee Tracy telling me before the competition that she's only really been healthy and been able to train hard for about a month and a half. And in gymnastics, that's not a long time.
Not at all. I was asking Amanda about the new code before the meet and how she thinks about it. And she actually said she likes that the new code focuses on dance more than the power skills.
And that error on the dismount could be indicative of only having a month and a half to train. You saw Mary Lee with the big nod of the head. Mary Lee been around a long time, coached J.C. Phelps and Amanda Borden to that 1996 Olympic team gold. Jetter obviously a little disappointed, but again, for her, she has qualified to the Visa Championships, and she is disappointed. You never want to go out there and have a bad performance, but for her, this is a warm-up. This is a tune-up. When it counts, it's going to be in a couple weeks, and she needs to put it together then. You know, I read in her bio, this is kind of funny, reading her bio, they talk about when did you start gymnastics or why did you start gymnastics? And her bio, it said, started after she walked on the edge of the bathtub. My first thought is, who's watching this kid? Has she got no supervision walking on the edge of the bathtub? Because that's dangerous.
How ironic, because when I was 7 years old, I'd go in my parents' bathroom and do bike handsprings on the edge of our bathtub.
Here's her teammate, Cassie Whitcomb, 16 years old. This is her first competition as a senior. And Cassie, like her teammate Jetter, she is coming back from a difficult year as well. She had a stress fracture in her back, and again, has only really had about a month and a half or 2 months of decent training. So Mary Lee Tracy talking about her too. The two young studs just mentioned, you know, it's a little bit skittish, a little bit unsure of what to expect, because we're used to doing a lot of numbers, and those numbers build confidence. So these athletes coming in without the reps under their belt, the belt they're used to, but still, they have a great ability to put up some bigger teams. She doesn't look too pleased, and as a gymnast, that's not a good feeling. We've all been there. And there's the score, 12.7, and again, a disastrous score. 7.5, though. I know she fell, Tasha, but a 7.5, that's 2.5 points off.
Well, falls are worth a point, so already there, she's down. Huge.
Wow. In 2008, Cassie was third all around at the Visa Championships for the junior division. This, again, her first year as a senior.
Talking to her before the meet, she has a new skill in this routine, an endo, right there. First time ever competing it.
Man, she's got some serious toe point. Her toes are actually pointing back towards her head. It looks like they're pointing so far. Now again, Tasha, it looked like a good routine. One handstand looked pretty flat, but can we expect another point and a half in execution deductions, more than that?
You know, I thought it was a good routine, but a little sluggish. The giants and releases and stallers just weren't as powerful as I'd like to see.
Yvonne Hong on vault. Tell you what, not one of her better events, but that was a beautiful Yurchenko double full. Best one I've seen her do.
That was very clean.
And you talk about clean, usually in the air on those, we see a lot of gymnasts with their feet split apart. Even some of the best gymnasts in the world, when they do that, they have a little bit of a foot split, but those were like super glued, amazing. Our first shot of Kayla Williams, an interesting story. 16 years old, she was junior level 10 national champion, but really, a diamond in the rough. She sent in a videotape a couple of years ago to be invited to a camp at the ranch in Texas, and was originally turned down and then was spotted by Steve Rybacki at a competition and said, we've got to get this girl out there. She has got some skills. As you can see by that double layout, this is one of her best events.
Wow. Watch right here. This is a side pass, but she does a triple twist.
Wow.
You don't even see guys doing that.
Hey, easy. That was not long ago. That was a major diagonal pass, it seems like, not long ago. And to do it down the side is ridiculous. Unbelievable, and that is a spot she can make, possibly make the world championship team this fall. And after we're done getting Kayla Williams' footprints off the roof of the college, the auditorium, we will be back with more live coverage from Universal Sports. Back live in Veterans Memorial Auditorium in Des Moines, Iowa. And I need a translation here, Tasha. Is that a good expression, or is that not such a good expression?
From what I remember, I think it's a good one.
Okay, good. I was getting a little nervous there. Here's Olivia Courtney, going to make another appearance, and you can see what she's done so far tonight. as she gets ready for her two best events. We heard Jeff Wood rather talk about these two being floor and vault after she finished beam, and let's see if she can live up to the billing. Outstanding tumbling. Evaluate, though, what we talked about earlier, the dance. You know, that's a bigger part of the routine, is that she lived up to the billing on the dance side as well as the tumbling.
That's right. Normally, you wouldn't see a lot of dance from a girl like this, but with the new code, she has to dance.
We'll be back with more in moments. Back on the floor, taking a look at Olivia Courtney, getting the talking to from Jeff Wood, who she describes as type of coach where it's either really good or really bad. He's a pretty intense guy. And there's the score, 14.45. Just under that 9.0 mark for the execution. Really not a bad score compared to what we've seen tonight.
Great score with the new code.
There's Yana, her first two events. Not bad, a little bit rough on bars, not quite the execution that she wanted to, but again, warming up for the rest of the year, and here we're going to see her on balance beam in a couple moments.
Talking with her mom earlier, Yana's not full strength coming into this meet. She actually had the flu for the last 10 days, been on antibiotics, is getting better, but still catching up with her.
Yana really having a great quadrennium leading up to the games. We talked about that silver medal she won at the World Championships in 2006 that went along with two other individual events. Silver medals, but that just made it that much more surprising not to see her on the floor in Beijing.
You know, leading up to the Olympic year, Yana was known as that consistent gymnast, and we're not seeing the same consistency as we used to.
And that's indicative right there. But again, we talked about her being sick coming up into this competition. And just in general, you don't want to peak at the qualifying meet. They have a few weeks yet to go before the big show, and you know, you're not going to be on your game. You got to have something to work on, but definitely regardless, you don't want to come off the apparatus. Little shy on that double front, the power squat at the end of that, not the way she wants to finish, but that the signature dismount from Yana, the double front.
You know, John, a decent routine, well, without the fall, but I think she has a lot of work to do before the Visa Championships. I really do.
over to the floor exercise and talk about somebody who can scrape the ceiling on this event. Keetra Hunter, outstanding on the floor exercise, on the vault. Two events, actually, that she could be considered for the world championship team, which will be picked after the Visa Championships, talking to Kathy Kelly before this competition. Women's Program Director for USA Gymnastics. She brought her up and said, keep an eye on this kid right here. Wow. Awesome.
I've actually never heard the vocals in the music, but apparently with the new code, you're allowed to have vocals with no words, or I should say voice with no words.
Amazing just to stay on her feet, but that is going to, they're going to kill her on that.
You can see there she's losing it a little bit. His jumps weren't as springy as I saw in warm-up. Oh.
An event where she's looking to make a mark. That's not the mark she wanted to make. Keetra Hunter from Hills Gymnastics, coached by the legendary Kelly Hill, who's had the opportunity to coach amazing gymnasts like Dominique Dawes and Courtney Capetz. She'll have to step it up a little at the Visa Championships to be in at the World Championships. When we come back, more gymnastics live from Veterans Memorial Auditorium and Universal Sports. Taking a look at the standings after the third rotation, Ivana Hong, 43.35 in the lead, followed by Olivia Courtney. And we still have a junior in the top three, Sabrina Vega, tied with Cassie Whitcomb from Cincinnati Gymnastics. Exciting competition so far, and I want to hear what an Olympic champion has to say about this competition so far. Let's go back onto the floor for another CoverGirl update with Nastia Lukin. Nastia, what do you think of the competition so far?
I think everybody's doing a great job. Ivana, my personal teammate, actually is in the lead, and she is on her last event, which is bars, and she has completely redone her routine since she's been with us. So a few upgrades, but she's still working her way up there. And also my other teammate, Rebecca Bross, who got injured a few days ago here while we were training, she'll also be doing bars, so look out for that as well. And Sabrina is also in the top three, like you said, and she's just a junior this year, but very up and coming, and has a bright future ahead of her.
Nastia, we saw you talking to Sam over there. What were you guys talking about?
Sorry, to who?
We saw you talking to Sam over there on the floor. What were you guys talking about?
It's funny because we were both a little bit nervous, and we were both telling each other, like, we've been to the Olympics, so I am pretty sure that, you know, we can do this whole classic thing, but it's just those first-time nerves getting back out there on the floor and competing again first time since the Olympics.
Hey, in the first thing that you said, you mentioned teammate like three times. And talking to your dad before the competition, he talked about how you've really become a leader, not just in your own gym, but with the national team. Is that something that you've consciously tried to do, or has it just come naturally? Is it something that you've developed over the years, becoming a leader of those teams?
I guess it's a little bit more natural to me, but it also helps that we had seven other girls here at the Classic, so it was kind of like I was the leader in of my team from WOGA. But now that I am pretty old for gymnastics, I guess I'll be 20 this year, but I do feel a little bit more of the leader of the national team, and it's definitely a different role, but I really like that role, and because of my experience and everything that I've been through, I think that I can really help everyone out.
Besides gymnastics these days, Nastia, what are you doing?
Nothing really. No. I'm traveling a lot, but mostly I'm just training and trying to get back at it and really compete, because that's what I love to do and I have a passion for. So hopefully at championships I'll be doing a few more events. But other than that, I'm doing some modeling. I just recently went to the ESPYs, so other appearances and obligations that I've had to do, but trying to stay in the gym as much as possible.
Well, congratulations on that ESPY. Thanks, Nastia, for that second CoverGirl update of the competition. Speaking of CoverGirl, I don't think Valeria is going to be a CoverGirl model anytime soon, but...
No, but I heard they were signing you.
Yeah, well, I need definitely a makeover, but we don't need to talk about that. I think we need to get back to competition. What do you think?
I agree.
There's Keetra Hunter. Saw moments ago on the floor exercise a disappointing finish to an event where she can really make a mark, and the score will not be good. But again, she's got a lot to focus on in the future, possibly even a world championship team if she can put it together on that event in particular and on vault. Another look at Kayla Williams, getting ready to go on the vault as well. And she is very similar to Keetra in that she's outstanding on floor and vault. And again, in two events where Team USA doesn't really excel. So this is an opportunity for a couple of lesser known athletes to make a mark and to step up there and be thrown literally onto the world stage here in just a few months.
That's right. Neither one of them could be a huge asset for the U.S. team at Worlds and even in 2012.
Is that the look of intensity or a look of fear? I'm not, that's some serious focus right there.
Oh God, with this gymnast, it has to be intensity.
We saw her launch into the stratosphere on floor exercise. You're gonna see that again here on vault. She does have a couple of very difficult vaults, which you do need to have if you're gonna be medaling at a world championships or contend at a world championships. You have to have two.
Wow.
Beautiful, just that big step on the landing. But again, like Ivana Hong, feet glued together in the air, and if she can master that landing, it's gonna be a huge score.
Okay, I don't know about you, but John, but it looks like going into her vault and tumbling, she really doesn't try that hard. Her run isn't super quick. She kinda just jogs down the runway and gets so much power and height. I mean, look at that height.
And that's gotta be frustrating. If you're one of those girls that you gotta eat everything you can out of your body to get that power, and you see her just kinda trotting down that runway, launching herself off that board. It's quite amazing. The first time I saw her was actually at a competition in Tennessee, the Flip Fest Invitational. And I remember sitting there watching her floor. I had no idea who this girl was, but I saw her do, again, a very similar routine that she did tonight with that amazing side pass, triple twist. I immediately got onto my phone and text messaged a couple of college coaches that I knew and said, hey, you've got to check this girl out. She is unbelievable on floor and vault. And so I saw her here today and I go, I remember that girl. And I remember what an impression she made on me. So we'll see. Hopefully she can keep making that impression, more importantly on the powers that be down the table over here, Marta Caroli and company. Here we go with vault number two.
Wow.
It was a good vault, but she's capable of a more difficult vault. I saw her warming up a handspring one and a half twist. That was just a half.
That's right. Not a hard vault, but an amazing landing. Again, it's just the CoverGirl Classic, and I'm sure she's planning a much harder vault for the Visa Championships.
Yeah, she did warm up a few of the one and a half twists, but they were ankle stingers, as I like to call them. She ended up a little bit short and probably playing a little bit safe tonight. She can't play it too safe because she still does need to qualify. She's one of those athletes that needs to earn her spot to the Visa Championships, and she needs to pull out all the stops, although that second vault will likely not count towards her score to qualify. Here's Olympic silver medalist Sam Peschek back again. She's going to be on the balance beam here in a few moments. Again, only doing two events. Getting back in the swing of things, coming back from that ankle injury that plagued her after the Olympic Games.
Now coming into this meet, Sam actually has a torn labrum, and that's why she's not doing bars. Small tear.
That's also why she's not pitching anymore. She has to take a little bit of time off. She's just in the bullpen.
She does look like she's on the right track, though. In workout yesterday, I saw her do some really, really nice double layouts on floor.
I talked to Sam a little bit about, hey, what you been doing since the Olympic Games? It's always fun to hear what the gymnasts get to do, or any Olympic athletes. It's kind of out of their comfort zone a little bit. And She goes, the most fun thing I did was learn to surf out in Hawaii. And she said she learned to do a handstand on a surfboard, which...
What?
That's pretty cool. She did say, however, upon completion of the handstand, she fell over the other way and pulled the surfboard onto her head. So the dismount wasn't quite what she wanted, but the handstand itself was evidently at least a 9.9 under the old code.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
That's a huge combination, standing full back pike.
You called that combination right from the start. A lot of girls doing that. Smiling a little, so she's okay, but man, that's gonna leave a mark.
Right before the fall, I was about to say she's on fire. I mean, everything has been great so far, but it's a tough fall.
An uncharacteristic fall, but honestly, I was with you, Tasha. Both her and Nasty, you think, wow, they're going to be rusty. But both of them, on beam in particular, I'm totally impressed. The amplitude on Sam's acro skills is outstanding. Back over to the uneven bars, Reagan Corville. And we talked about that 13.5 being important to qualify to championships. We saw all of her scores so far at or above that average. So, and this is a big one. This is one where the judges can really nail you on the execution. If you give them any opportunity, they're going to take it. So this is a huge routine for Reagan.
Oh.
Oh, and right off the bat, devastating.
Oh. Well, you got the fall. That'll be a point. Hitting her feet on the bar, that'll be another 5/10.
You know, she's on the right track, and she has to know right now that her opportunity at the Visa Championships may have just evaporated with that bar team. That was catastrophic as far as her opportunity to qualify, and her coach has got to know it. She's got to know it. And for someone who's come so far, especially with her injury last year and having such a bright future a couple years ago before that injury, this is going to be another huge roadblock. We'll see what the judges do with it, but she's put herself in a deep, deep hole that she most likely will not get out of. We will find out the fate of Reagan Corville and the rest of the field when we come back to Des Moines, Iowa with more live gymnastics. Back in Des Moines, we have the junior who is surprising the field. Not Tasha and I, of course, because we're experts, but Sabrina Vega in the top three, getting ready for her uneven bar routine. Just rolling through this competition.
I think she's surprising everyone today. I mean, as a junior coming into a senior competition, you think they might be intimidated or a little nervous. She's on fire.
You know, she might lack a little bit of that finish that we see from some of the best in the world in that event, but you could see, you got flashes of what's to come.
Oh, that's right. She definitely has potential. Needs to work on the body lines a little bit. A few handstands and giants with her head out, her back a little arched, but I mean, for a junior, she's just doing amazing.
And I love seeing that smile on her face from start to finish today.
Okay, little things on the handstand are very good. Okay, you can breathe now.
You can look at Nastia, seriously. Is she trying to go for like a Nobel Prize or something? I mean, she's on the media, she's on her phone, she's getting the bars ready for Ivana, and she probably just did a modeling shoot behind the bleachers somewhere.
She's probably booking appearance as she's scraping the bar for her teammate.
Does she not know what that chalk is going to do to that sweater? I mean, seriously, you got to be a little more careful. Sabrina, seriously, she has been a showstopper and has not stopped smiling from the time they marched into the arena. She started gymnastics, just put this into perspective how we're getting a little older, at least people tell us that. She started when we competed in the Olympics in 2000. That's when this girl started gymnastics.
Only 9 years doing so well at a prestigious meet like this.
That's awesome. And another look at Ivana Hong getting ready for her uneven bar routine. Those bars better be chalked right, or I know who I'm blaming. Good performance for Ivana tonight. Low score coming on floor exercise, which again, we talked about being the lowest scoring event, really, under the new code. Seriously, those two need to stop having so much fun. Bridget Cacuato, fellow junior, also having an outstanding competition.
I'm giving her a cute award after the meet.
The cute award? Because you were the one who had it last, is that what you're trying to say?
Stop it, John.
Valeri with that focus, that scowl.
On balance beam, the score for Caitlin Clark on precision, 14.05. Now on balance.
Oh, you could see it. Deep center field on that one.
What a horrible finish to an amazing routine.
And I watched her warm up a few of those double layoffs, and they tended to go away from the bar, but that one was definitely a shot to deep center field. And again, a great routine. Form immaculate.
Talk about that toe point too, huh?
Doesn't get any better than that.
Just a little too aggressive. It's a good try.
Good try. Being positive, you gotta be positive, it's early.
Let's take a look at the dismount. Let's see what happened here. Yeah, she just pings off the bar way too early. And there's the result.
Yeah, really almost went out of the camera there. The cameraman had to keep up with her. But all in all, you know, she's, again, like a common theme tonight, really, for a lot of these athletes, have overcome a lot. Had tumultuous years, but she is on the right track, and she loves where she's at. Talking to her about being at WOGA with Nastia and Valeri. She's where she needs to be, and she is heading in the right direction, and I think the best for Ivana is yet to come. I think I just heard her say something about the bar being chalking correctly on that dismount. Is it?
Okay.
And John, she doesn't even have her earpiece in.
Sorry. How did you feel after your first competition back since the whole summer and being on the Olympic team as an alternate, and how did you feel coming back?
It was great, definitely coming out here in front of a crowd. First time in a year, I mean, it's a little shaky here and there, but I mean, that's what this meet was for, and I'm glad we came and came to this classic.
good. It was definitely a good start for you, and you nailed all your routines except for your dismount, the final event. But what were you nervous for, bars mostly or some other event?
I was pretty calm on beam until I got up there, and then I was like, whoa, this is my first meet in a year, and a little shaky, but I mean, as I said, this is our first meet, and I'm glad we came and got all the jiggles out.
That's right. Good job. And now our other teammate is about to go on the bars, Rebecca.
I think I got to ask her what she means by got all the jiggles out. I've never actually
the
heard
jiggles.
Somebody say that. Rebecca Brough, somebody that we were so excited to watch when we got here to this competition, and talk about a tough-as-nails athlete. This girl is tough and has dealt with a lot of setbacks over the last year. A big knee injury last fall, which was preceded by an ankle injury. She gets here, looks rock star-like, and all the buzz is about her, and she re-aggravates an ankle on something as simple as a basic dismount off beam, and she just rolled it and said, only doing bars tonight.
That's right, John. I mean, watching her in training, I honestly would have said, I'm going to bet that she wins tonight. But after that ankle injury, she's only able to do bars.
One thing I love about watching her bars is she's so precise. Really nails those positions and those handstands.
Wow, that was a huge Jaeger.
Most likely will not do her dismount here. And that was the plan. Obviously, you can see her ankle taped up right there. Playing it safe. No need to take in any unnecessary risks. And Tasha, I did talk to the officials with USA Gymnastics about her possibilities of being in BISA Championships because she has not qualified yet. And she will petition to the championships and most likely will get in. Looks like her number might have gotten pinned literally to her back on that dismount.
I think it almost stabbed her in the back. No, but you're right, John. I mean, she more than deserves to be petitioned to the championships.
I mean, look at that kid. I mean, you talk about pound for pound the greatest athletes in the world. You're watching some of the greatest athletes in the world. And if you don't believe me, ask Rebecca Brough for tickets to the gun show. I mean, seriously, look at that. She is amazing.
Okay, Becca, how did you feel today? I know you got injured a little bit a few days ago on beam, but you were, I mean, being able to train with you, you were looking great, but you were only able to compete bars. But how did you feel having to save that for the very last event?
Well, I mean, it was kind of boring having to sit around the whole time, but I was ready for it, and whenever it came, I was going to be ready, and I did my best.
You did a great routine, and so now that you're going to be able to come back in the gym and try and get ready for championships, is that the plan?
Yes, it is, very much. Just trying to work hard till then.
Good. Well, hopefully you'll be out there by my side with me.
Thank you.
Thank you, Nastia. Nice job. Back over to the balance beam with Amanda Jetter, her last performance of tonight. Other than that bar dismount, really has, I've been impressed. You know, she's got flashes like we talked about with Sabrina on her bar team. She's got flashes of brilliance, and if she can just put four events together and stay healthy, this kid's gonna be a contender for years to come.
Oh.
And on cue makes a huge error there, however, on an extremely difficult move.
Not to mention, that's actually a new scope for her, the first time she's ever competed it in elite competition. You know, I don't know about you, John, but I really feel like the nerves have gotten the best of Amanda Jeter today. Watching her train yesterday, she's just so solid. But today, with the pressure of the competition, I think maybe it was domino effect. One fall, and then it just kind of went from there.
That might be the star of the show right there, Tasha. Sabrina Vega having an outstanding competition.
Hi!
And she's already learning how to ham it up. I mean, seriously.
I hope you're watching.
Oh my gosh, she's so adorable. I want to put her in my back pocket and take her home.
There's her teammate. Actually, fellow gymnast Mackenzie Cuquato there, hamming it up a little bit. Ivana Hong on the right track. I'm excited to watch her at the Visa Championships coming up later this year and hopefully at the World Championships. And again, a couple years ago, I thought this kid is going to be one to watch in Beijing, and it didn't work out the way she wanted to, but the story is not over. It continues, and it's going to be a fun one to watch.
You know, you're right. She said she came here and had to get the jiggles out, and, you know, I think that's what she did. I'm excited to see her at the Visa Championships.
And she's getting jiggy with it. We'll be back with final scores and final thoughts in moments live from Des Moines, Iowa on Universal Sports.
The CoverGirl Classic has been brought to you by CoverGirl. Check out CoverGirl Lash Blast and Lash Blast Luxe at CoverGirl.com.
Here are the standings of tonight's competition. You can see Olivia Courtney, 57.4. Our junior, the star of the show, Sabrina Vega, 56.75. Rounding out the top five, Ivana Hong having a nice comeback. Caitlin Clark, who we did not get to see tonight, but also had an outstanding competition. And another junior, Bridget Cuquato, rounding out the final results in fifth place. Back down to the floor with our breakout reporter of the night, Nastia Lukin, with the star of the show, Sabrina Vega.
Sabrina, you had an excellent competition today, and this is your first competition since the European Tour, and you looked amazing. Did you upgrade anything, or have you kept the same routine since?
No, I had the same routines, but I like polished up from the time from the European Tour, and I guess it paid off.
It definitely did. And so now, as you look ahead towards the U.S. Championships, which are only in a few weeks, are you going to upgrade anything, or just do a little bit more polishing?
No, I think I'm going to do a little more polishing to make sure I get everything set and then just go out and do it.
Good. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Back to you guys.
So, Nastia, real quick, you know, you had a couple of big moments tonight. Balance beam back in the mix, but also on the floor, first time as a reporter. Which of those moments stands out more in your mind right now at the end of this competition?
It's a tough one, but I'm definitely going to have to say being back out there and competing on the beam. I've been, you know, wanting to get back out here on the floor, and it is my first time since the Olympic Games. So I'm just so excited to finally be back out doing what I love to do and what I have a passion for. So this comes in a close second, though.
Well, good. We're very happy to see you out back on that floor, and we hope to see a lot of great things from you in the future. Now, Tasha, a lot of interesting things tonight, a lot of great things tonight. What stands out in your mind as things to look for as we go forward?
Well, definitely, Sabrina caught the hearts of all the viewers today. She was outstanding, not to mention a ham on camera, and just an absolute joy to watch.
Well, certainly we'll watch her as we get to the Visa Championships, but also there's going to be some other athletes who didn't compete tonight, some that weren't full strength, like Rebecca Barras, who hopefully will be back full strength at the Visa Championships. And as we look forward to the World Championships, some bright spots, and hopefully the U.S. can get right back on that horse, so to speak, and head in the direction that they were in Beijing.
That's right. I was very impressed with Kayla. And also Keitra, great, great floor and vaulters, and definitely an asset to the team, especially the world team.
I'm sure the powers that be are right now sitting back thinking to themselves, who is going to be the next standout competitor? Certainly a lot of options, and certainly some kids that weren't here tonight. And I know it's fun to see those Olympians back out there, and I can't help but wonder, you know, which is the next Olympian from 2008 that's going to be out there? I know rumor has it that there's some training.
Definitely.
I know we saw Chelsea Memel sitting down here. I know she's in the gym a little bit, and And Alicia Sacramone also was out at camp this summer, and she said she was hopefully training. We can see Olivia Courtney there, the all-around champion from tonight's competition. The Visa Championships, as we talked about, will be televised live. They will be on NBC 13th through the 15th and Universal Sports as well. So make sure you guys tune into that. It's going to be a great competition. And again, another brick in the road on the way to London. It'll give us a great opportunity to see what shape the U.S. team will take, not just for the women, but also for the men. Such a relief after the competition's over. It's just a weight's taken off your shoulder. You get to hang out and mug it up with your teammates a little bit.
We see there the winner of our competition, Olivia Courtney.
Well, I'm looking forward to hopefully working with you again, Tasha. It was a great competition tonight, and I'm looking forward to seeing more great gymnastics at the Visa Championships. Coming up again, the 13th through the 15th on NBC and on Universal Sports. Make sure you all tune in again. For Tasha Schweikert, I'm John Roethlisberger. We'll see you guys again soon. Thank you all for tuning in to the CoverGirl Classic.